Okay. I'm back. Yeah, it actually took a long time, actually, trying to find an appropriate time to record. But yeah, nevertheless, I'm back, so without further ado, let's continue with this recording, shall we? Yeah. 5 of Clannad year. I suddenly woke up, you know? Feels like I was dreaming. Or rather, some remaining sensation tells me that I was dreaming. I yawn as I look at the watch. It's just 7 o'clock a.m., huh? I definitely mustn't sleep for the second time today.
In any case, I should just get up.
I crawled out of my bed, you know. I arrived at our meeting place 15 minutes early. Kotomi still hasn't arrived, huh? Will she come early or will she come exactly in time? I was thinking which of the two, but I'm not particularly worried about that. I lean against the wall and wait. It's quiet, you know. The birds are chirping high in the sky. The clouds are floating separately. I casually check around to see if Kyo is hiding.
She already did it yesterday, so she'll probably arrive doing a Tsu-Kun on us today as well.
What the hell is gonna do a Tsu-Kun on you? You pervert. I try to retaliate using the same Tsu-Kun line that she would probably say, but I got no response.
Alright, it's settled then. Today's gonna be a fun date. This would be a genuine date with only two people.
No matter what happens, I definitely wouldn't. Won't let a Tsu-Kun enter.
That's impossible.
There was no response, even when I did a quick bokeh gag. This is making me a little sad in some way. It was tiring doing a comedy act alone. Not to mention, Kotomi would probably be gazing and spacing out as she walks about. She should be arriving in about 5 minutes, you know? For some strange reason, 10 minutes had already passed. But that doesn't matter at the moment. I put my hand in my pocket and wait for her familiar footsteps. I still think I can lure her out with something, though. I felt a small pain piercing my heart every time I think of that. Guess I'm still not used to this kind of feeling. I stare at my shadow as the bright sun shines down on me. Suddenly, I remembered about that gentleman I met the other day.
機会があったら彼女に伝えてほしい。私たちは あの時のことを今でも後悔していると。
I wonder what he did he mean by that. Should I tell Kotomi about it? I don't know the full details, but it seems like there's nothing that can be done even if those words were to come from my mouth. I sigh as I realize that I ended up destroying my mood, even though I finally became excited. I shook my head and closed my eyes, you know? But even still, our conversation at the time continues.
君は彼女の恋人かね?
Not right now, but,
I think I'll just replay that and stuff. Yeah. I was writhing with embarrassment. And just in front, observing that state of mind is Kotomi.
Huntington-butobio?
Huh? Wrong! And just what kind of disease is that?
神経疾患の一つ 顔面体幹視視に急速かつ無目的な不随運動を示すことが特徴.
You don't need to explain. Hand me your things, I'll carry them.
I take the cloth bag that is in Kotomi's hand. It's in a different shape from yesterday. It's a flat box as I look up over it. There's a stainless thermos flask inside. Kotomi was still looking at me with worried eyes.
Tomoya-kun, 本当に病気じゃない?
I was just thinking about some things, you know?
考え事?
That embarrassing phrase surfaces again. She stares her right at me.
Not right now, but no, I'm thinking how nice it would be to be like that.
That's right. I haven't confessed to Kotomi yet. Yesterday would have been officially the perfect time to do that, and these feelings would have already been settled then. I wonder if it'd be better if I'm the one going to confess. I have a hunch that if I drag this too long, something very bad would happen between Kotomi and I. Think I should just stop being only a mere friend in order to progress with Kotomi more than this. Besides, if it's Kotomi, I think I'll be the only one disappointed, or she'll quickly say okay to me. But it also feels like I'm only getting a triple question mark response. There's a possibility that something tasty will happen, like she'll end up blushing bright red and be bothered. There's also a potential that she'll cast aside an unknown serious bokeh character. The result is really hard to read. Ikuzo!
Hey, Kotomi.
Hmm?
If by chance I'm,
I stare at Kotomi. Kotomi's eyes flicker. She looks at me and opens her soft lips a little.
Tomoya-kun-ga?
She tilts her head and waits for me to continue.
If I'm actually a robot inside, what would you do?
The confession I was planning ended up being a joke. With me being the heavy poke drunkard.
Oh.
My partner looks at me with a familiar silence and serious look.
Missile to ka. Uteru?
No, I'm absolutely not loaded with any kind of weapons.
Jibaku sochi. Tsuiteru?
I'm sad to say that I also don't have that.
So nanda.
She seems a bit disappointed, you know?
それなら分解してみていい?
Then I'll have you reassemble me to the way I was then, please?
Tomoya-kun の組み立て、どのくらい難しいの?
I also haven't tried disassembling myself, so I don't even know.
目覚まし時計より簡単?
I try to compare in my mind my own blueprint and an alarm clock.
It's probably a good match. I mean, by the way, you disassembled an alarm clock when you were a kid, didn't you?
Hmm.
Did the reassembly go all right?
Neji ga hitotsu amatchatta no.
That seems so typical to throw in a Tsu-Kun-mi for.
Demo ne, kumitate naoshita ato mo kachikochi genki ni ukoite tan dakedo, bell ga naridashitara tomaranaku natchatte.
Uh-oh. You probably got scolded for that.
She quietly nods after thinking for a little bit.
時計さんには大切なお仕事があるから邪魔をしてはいけないって。時計さんが自然に壊れてしまったら、その時は分解して仕組みを教えてもらいなさいって。
Somehow, that's a strange way to get scolded. But that's a good experience, I guess.
She showed a small but happy smile.
Tomoya-kun.
What is it?
もしも私が...
And like that, she stares straight at me. For some reason, cheeks suddenly blushed as I wait for her response.
なんでもないの。
そうか。
She smiled once again with a hint of shyness. That
for some reason, our topic is changing to something embarrassing. By the way, it seems you're wearing the same dress as yesterday.
Tomoya-kun, この服…
Yeah. She looks down on her own dress and asks in a low voice.
It's just… I think it suits you well. I also said that yesterday too, though.
Yokatta.
She becomes relieved.
夜のうちにお洗濯したの。
あ？
トモヤ君と二人きりで会うときはこれにしようって決めてたから。
I see.
Her choice of clothing is quite mature, yet doesn't quite fit with her personality, you know? That's right, I think Kyo also said something before, like,
You're unexpectedly adult-like.
And something like,
Her breasts are surprisingly big, too.
I shake my head to drive away those worldly thoughts.
Well then, where should we go today?
とっても素敵な場所があるの。
Oh no.
きっとともやくんも大好きだと思うの。
Oh no.
That place. Could it be that I also know of it?
うん。ともやくんも知ってる場所なの。
そうかそうか。And where is that place?
あのね、学校の図書室なの。
She says so with a bit of pride. Somehow I managed to suppress the urge to do a double Tsu-Kun hand attack at her chest and the back of her head. If she doesn't even respond to a bokke gag that got recycled, then there's no doubt that Kyo is sleeping at her house.
I understand, so let's go now.
Tomoya-kun.
Kotomi stands next to me. We started walking while our shoulders touched each other. The entire school doesn't have the presence of people completely opposite of what it is, usually. Even students with club activities aren't here because of the holidays. The sunlight streams silently through the leaves onto the pathway. I had a bad premonition as we got near the school building.The door to the shoe rack needs a proper key.
You don't have the key to enter the school building, right?
うん。私が持ってるのは図書室の鍵だけなの。
ああ、そうかそうか。
私専用なの。私、名誉図書委員なの。
I'm fine with that, but I wonder why.
I couldn't suggest going to a different place now that we were here.And then, Kotomi started walking briskly.
こっちなの?
With her usual quick pace, she heads by the edge of the school building and turns the corner.
We wouldn't get anywhere even if we go that way.
We suddenly stopped under a hallway window as I immediately followed her.
ここから入れるの?
I see. Like the solid snake, eh?She jolts and loosens the window frame without any words. The window suddenly opened with a thud sound.
ほら、ね。
Somehow the locks here seem to be left broken.
I see. This is your hobby, right? Breaking into people's stuff. never mind. I'll just go first then.
I give back the things to Kotomi for a while and...Put my hands on the window frame.
中に入ったらね、すぐにお靴を脱ぐの。出ないと土足で怒られちゃうから。
Nope, that's not the reason why we're going to get scolded.
もしかして、やっぱり制服着てないから?
That's not it either, though I think it is, kind of. There are countless reasons, so I'll go on ahead. Come on.
There really wasn't anyone inside the school except Kotomi and I. The atmosphere is different compared to when I'm skipping and strolling around during lessons.
It's like looking at a backstage that's slightly more out of this world than usual. A strange feeling. Kotomi just walks in without thinking about such things.
到着なの?
She took out the familiar key in her possession and opened the sliding door of the library. The quiet and deserted room where you can only see books. Even though I came here last Friday, it appears as if the state of this room has completely changed. Is it because of the closed window that the scent of the dust and paper is stronger than usual? We'll find out. Furthermore,
why was the library this huge?
She nods for no reason. Kotomi probably also saw the library like this before she met me. Kotomi advances to the usual spot and immediately takes off her shoes and socks. And as always, she jumps in circles as she's going to collapse. After that, she walks to the edge of the wall and leaves open the east side window. I could feel the cold air disappearing as the light swayed along with the curtain, although this may be the last time that the cold air will enter, because it's May 5th of Clannad year. She brings out a mop from the tool's locker. She diligently wipes the floor many, many times with her slender arm. Kotomi, black cloth and barefooted amongst the countless numbers of old books, just as I thought, was somehow fresh and nostalgic. The last thing she took out was the cushion, which she placed on the floor.
これで準備完了なの?
As Kotomi says that, the library becomes a pretty snug fit place.
Tomoya-kun, onaka suite nai?
That's right, I did wake up early today, so I'm a little bit hungry.
Chotto hayai kedo, ohiru gohan ni suru?
That's fine with me, but I haven't brought anything yet. Guess I should have brought something outside.
Kotomi looks straight at me and it seems she's about to say something.
Tomoya-kun dato, chotto sukunai kamoshirenai kedo.
She brought forward the cloth bag containing the boxed lunch, which she has placed on the desk.
Kore, futari de tabetai no.
She takes out a flat paper square box from inside it. I'd be wondering about it when I was holding it.
Is that some sort of pizza?
Kotomi slowly shakes her head.
Apple pie nano.
Ah, soka.
Hajimete tsukutte mita kara. Umaku dekita ka wakaranai nda kedo.
She opens the paper box. A bit of sweet scent suddenly escapes. It's a round pie with fox-colored burnt marks here and there. It's luxuriously thick and round, and there are lattice shape decorations attached to it. It seems there's a starch syrup on the surface, and it doesn't look different from those sold in stores.
This is genuine, huh?
焼き具合はうまくできたと思うの。 リンゴはちゃんと紅玉を使って、 バターも無塩バターなの。 仕上げにラム酒で伸ばしたアプリコットジャムを塗ったの。
She really knows her cooking well.
But anyways, she rummages inside her cloth bag as she explains it to me wholeheartedly. Two paper plates, a plastic knife, forks, and, you know, paper cups. She lines up all the necessary things on the library reading desk. I also pull in a nearby chair and seat myself in front of the ready dining table.
紅茶もね。 初めてちゃんとお茶っ葉を使ってみたの。お茶っ葉はレディーグレーにしてみたの。She's finally
going to cut down the pie after pouring it in the aroma of the expensive black tea in the cup.
今から半分こするの。She
puts the knife in the big pie and cuts it. She first halves the pie, then she halves it again and again. It seems it's her first time earnestly cutting this, making me break and smile. The bake is semi-circular pie divided into four little pieces, eh? She then puts the slices on the two plates.
Hanbunko.
She presses to me. She presents to me the larger portion of she after she said that.
Yeah, arigato ne.
Itadakimashou.
Itadakimasu.
Reciting that, I stab the fork into the pie. I try stuffing all of the pie into my mouth as if I'm not some sort of savage. I wonder if she baked this morning. She baked this morning. Still slightly warm, and the sweetness is just right. Kotomi was gazing at me as I tasted it.
Is this really your first time eating this?
Oishiku nai?
No. I say it's unbelievably good. I mean,
the machine's malfunctioning again, eh? It seems she's having a hard time replying when she's really tense, so I guess I have to rephrase what I just said before.
Your homemade apple pie is really delicious. It's so delicious that it's kind of hard to believe that it's your first time making it. I could eat a lot of this if it's this delicious. Do you understand now?
She clears her mind. The wiring's finally connected.
Tomoya-kun, sore, hontou ni hontou?
It's really true. I mean, seriously.
Yokatta. Tottemo ureshii no.
Her smiling face seems like it's overflowing. I stop my hand and look at that face of hers unintentionally.
I just think that it's nice to see you smile. You had a hard facial expression when you first met.
Hajimete atta toki?
Oh yeah, her eyes shifted.
Ano toki wa kinchou shite ta shi, choppiri kowakatta kara.
She hangs her head a little as she answers.
Is that so?
She was nervous. I don't seem to understand what she meant by that. She drops her eyes as the pie she was eating as if embarrassed.
Can I have another piece?
Futari de futakire taberu to chōdo hanbunko nano.
What would you do with the other half after that?
Oyatsu ni nokoshite oku no.
Ah, soka soka.
She smiles like a little kid.
Gochisousama.
Gochisousama desu.
It was almost past noon when we finished eating. Usually we must clean up the library desk for the mess, but today we kinda held back. For now, both of us can do anything we like. Although, I realize that we don't have anything we can do in this room. Incidentally, I also realized that right now we're secretly together in this room. I look at Kotomi's appearance.
If this is gonna be that,
she puts her fingers together in front of her and moves them restlessly as if embarrassed.
Gonna be... What are we going to do now?
I try and ask her.
If it's going to be...
Kotomi also looks at the floor and thinks.
That, then...
She says it suddenly. So I thought. But she came silent again.
Together? What?
そっかそっか。一緒に5本を読みたいの。
Why?
That's what I thought. Or so I thought. Not.
Hey, isn't a book something you can't enjoy reading together? Well, we could also try though.
Our hobbies are different.
more than that, our reading speed is completely different, oh my gosh. Anyhow, I won't mind if we're kids looking at that picture book, but I don't think it would be that fun for us to do now. Kotomi's head is still inclined, looking at me. It was unusual thinking it over a face. If Kotomi really wants that, then I have no reason to hesitate.
Well, what book are we going to read?
Her gaze went everywhere as she starts to speak. She becomes silent again. I feel that today's Kotomi is a bit different from the usual. It seems she's opening up to me bit by bit, those things that she has been locking inside of her heart. Of course, I don't feel bad about that. It's just, how do I say it? It feels like she's moving at a quick pace. But in the end, Kotomi once said,
やっぱりいいの.
She gives me a modest smile, and it seems she decides to hide her treasure from me one more time. I think it might be because of me.
If that's the case,
I open my mouth.
Won't you let me hear you read books?
Huh?
Surprised, she tilts her head.
I like to watch Kotomi reading books, and I also like your voice. Is it a no?
Her facial expression changes to a really cheerful expression, just from me asking that.
とても素敵なの. Tomoya-kun, どんな本がいい?
That's right. Book that's been written by a Japanese novelist. Also, something that's fun to read, like Hayao Miyazaki's. And also, it's your favorite book.
日本の作家が書いた本で読むと楽しい気持ちになって私のお気に入りの本私探してみるの.
She stands up and runs towards the bookshelves.
Hey, Kotomi!
It seems I have no other choice but to wait. Exactly 20 minutes later, Kotomi returns from the forest of the bookshelves holding onto her chest a single book.
選んできたの.
Thanks for your hard work.
ともやくんが気に入るかどうかわからないけど.
We won't know unless you read it, right?
それじゃあ読むの.
Read the parts you like if it's long.
わかったの.
She seats on the yellow cushion. She then opens the cover and flips its pages.
よほど遠い過去のこと.秋から冬にかけての短い期間を私は変な家族の一員として過ごした. そしてその間に私は一つの恋をしたようである.
She started talking with a little difficulty. Only a little time has passed, but it seems it's obviously a short story. I listen carefully without worry. Honestly speaking, I'm glad that this was the content. Just listening to her musical voice echoing around is enough for me. Kotomi looks like she's in a daze during this time. Her voice has become smooth, and I can hear that each line carries a sentiment. I rest my chin in my hand, looking at her eyes that are chasing down letters with the fingers that place on the pages. And I daze off to blackness and darkness.
Where is this place? I can hear a sound from somewhere. A sound I haven't heard before, but still, it's a nostalgic sound.
Manzaishi Yosei Gakkou ni goukaku suru tame ni violin o reishu shiteru no.
Well, it would be impossible no matter what if that's how you practice.
Violin mandan nano.
I see. That's a new genre.
Kotomi strokes the violin and at the same time hums a meaningless song.
Tango?
I had a bad premonition as I turned around, and behind me was Furukawa. She was simmering something in a big pot.
What the hell is that pot for? Why are you boiling bread? And also, that pot somehow stinks, and it really stinks.
I peered inside a box that was placed on the floor. Whoa! The box is filled with squirming dango. Furukawa swoops a bread broth with a laddie and pours it to the loving dango. The big family of dango are becoming darker and darker one by one, very fast.
Dango-tachi-ga!
Oh no. Furukawa moves around in confusion as the whole family gets annihilated.
Okay.
The way they expanded was quite weird as well. I wonder if something happened with the function of my brain. Next to Furukawa's Fujibayashi, who was doing a fortune telling with playing cards for some strange reason. Shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. Scudder? She sluggishly but correctly lines up the cards on the floor.
Well, that's a sign.
わかりました.
Oh gosh. Who has schizophrenia? More than that, how did you know about that using fortune telling?
そんな見方こそが分裂心理というものなんです.
Oh god. Oh no. Oh no.
I was thinking about it's about time for you to show up. That's due to Furukawa's boiled bread, right?
パンを煮る工期は実に人間の心理を不健康にするものなのよ.
You're talking about nonsensical things, and your line have become weird too.
それも全くパンを煮る工期のためね.
Anyway, this is a dream, right? It must be right, because no matter what, everyone wouldn't be twisted unless if it's a dream. At least listen to people even in dreams.
すみません. 私、病院に行ってみなければなりません.
Oh no. You too. What you're talking about doesn't relate to us.
タンゴたちが、タンゴたちが!
Kotomi, who was sitting on the floor, was looking at me. Oh gosh. It appears I was watching a really bad dream. It was probably more the random dream rather than scary.
そうなんだ.
She stares at me as if I'm still having a dream, and then she narrows her eyes as if relieved. There was a closed book on the lap. Perhaps she's already finished reading it. I'm sorry. It seems I always end up sleeping whenever Kotomi starts to read books.
うん。私ね、眠ってるともやくんを見るの好きなの。
Me too. I like to sleep where Kotomi is. I return my gaze and stretch as I sit.
The inclining evening sunlight dyes the library book with an expressionless color. Two pieces of the cut apple pies are placed on the table, plate over the reading desk.
Tomoya-kun, soro-soro okiru ka na tte omotta kara, sakki kitte oita no.
The one you divided, huh?
Hanbunko na no.
The truth was, you planned to eat it at 3 o'clock, right?
5 時半 da kedo, oyatsu na no.
You're hungry, right?
Chotto dake peko peko.
Alright, let's eat then. Kotomi began preparing at once.
Kōcha, chotto osame chatteru kedo.
It's alright, it's warm enough.
She pours the remaining black tea in a paper cup she's holding and then we say,
Itadakimashou.
Itadakimasu. This is the second time we said that today. The texture of the apple is softer. Even the taste seems better.
It tastes better than during noon. I wonder if it's because I'm hungry.
Apple pie wa sametemo oishii kara.
Ah, soka soka.
The room has become darker and the only shining things from the setting sun are the outlines of the bookshelves. She probably won't be able to read books now. We can't make any light in the school building where there shouldn't be anyone.
Hey, Kotomi.
Hmm?
Once we eat this, let's head home.
Hmm.
She immediately understood what I told her, nodding obediently.
Compared to yesterday, which is more fun?
Her forelock sways, and she smiles happily. I put the last piece of the apple pie in my mouth, and I savored its flavor before I swallowed it.
Thanks for the food.
I put my hands together.
Tomoya-kun.
Kotomi didn't say anything for a while. I wonder how many times did she show that today? That face that looks like brooding about something. She took out something from the bottom of the cloth bag while I kept looking at her. It seems like an old book. She rubs the front cover to clean it, but the title is still illegible.
これ Tomoya-kun ni motteite hoshii no.
She gently places it in front of me.
But isn't this important to you?
I have a hunch, even though that I haven't looked inside. I'm sure she probably has read this hundreds and hundreds of times, too.
私はもう覚えちゃったから。
She smiles as if embarrassed.
But you see, I won't be able to read this book.
As I hesitate on accepting it, Kotomi said something surprising.
読まないでほしいの。
え?
読まないでほしいの。
The words piles up, making me more confused.
ただ、持っててくれるだけでいいの。
But...
Kotomi's eyes flicker. That feeling came back again. Her matureness and the child in her, which doesn't know anything. And the Kotomi that I don't know, which is hidden between them.
Alright then.
I took the book from her. I suddenly noticed that its skin has the feeling of being left for months, or even years.
Hey, Kotomi. The truth is,
you really want to read this together with me, right? I ended up swallowing those words. Kotomi slowly stands up. She advances her slender feet to the west side window and there she slowly turns to face me.
私、決めたの。ここにはできるだけ来ないようにするの。
Huh?
今はここにいても前みたいに楽しくないから。みんなといる方が楽しいから。 ともやくんといる方が楽しいから。だから私、みんなと一緒になるの。ちゃんと授業を受けて、先生の言うことをきちんと聞いて、クラスのみんなとも仲良くなって、本当はそうしなきゃいけないってずっと前から分かってたの。
She wasn't saying those to me. The bookshelves looked like historic ruins inside the backlight. The tens of thousands of books, bindings that came to watch Kotomi even now. It was as if they were carefully listening to Kotomi's voice. Kotomi bowed at them in the end.
Tomoya-kun, 帰ろ?
She then gave me a smile.
You should properly lock the door.
There was a small metallic sound that echoed inside Kotomi's purse. We then left the library and I'll be back to having a short nap during tomorrow's lunch break.
これで大丈夫なの?
She puts away a treasure key that has her own name. I'm sure that the chance she'll be using it will decrease. As for that, Kotomi should be getting more friends. We were crouching in the twilight, at the hallway where there's no one.If I compare it to a book, it probably means a single chapter has ended. I wonder what's waiting ahead.
Hikoze!
Kotomi unconsciously held onto my palm that was stretching out to her. I realized that this is the first time we've held hands together. And so, another day has passed. 5-6 of Clannad here.
But right now, I gotta go. So... Yeah, like and favor if you're enjoying this session of Clannad, the walkthrough, subscribe to become one of my HL viewers, and look forward to how it will unfold. But why hasn't this game ended? We'll find out soon. This is Yasashi Tsu-Kun, signing out. Have a good day, everybody. Stay sharp out there, and hopefully, relationships actually maintain like this one. So anyways, without further ado, gotta go. See ya, bye!